Let's go to our stock footage, I think, and let's see what we actually have. It's, there's really a lot of stock here, and it's not even as very good stock. So if we now click on this zebra here, and we can now, in this is the preview viewer, can now see our lovely stock footage here. So there's two ways of getting that down to the timeline, of course. One way would just be to drag it down like this and letting it go, and it'll be in the timeline. Just delete that. So another way would be to do in and out points. And you do an in and out point by pushing I on your keyboard, and then you'll see some of the footage. And then when you want to go out, you put O as out. And then you can just drag that down here. Also, if you want to either drag it this way, but you can also drag it out here, and you'll see this menu appear, and then you can just insert it here. You can override a clip, you can replace a clip, you can make the clip fit to fill, and place on top. And you can, if I place on top, it will not place anything on top because I have nothing underneath it. But that is also just to keep in mind that you can do it like this in DaVinci Resolve. So let's just, I don't know, now I have some animals. Maybe I have more animals here. Let's see if we have some animals. So this is where the ability to do smart bins would have been great, because I could have used that now. So I'll just do some in and out points here. Let's say lovely shot of an animal. And let's see if I drag that down, and I'll put that place on top. It will place it on top, and it will have now created a new video layer. So again, this is how to get some of your footage into the timeline by dragging it. So let's see if we have a clip more we could have fun with. No, let's, what is this we have here? The pyramids. Some ghosts. Okay. Let's see what we have. Yeah, an animal more. So let's just use this. And then just do an out point, and I'll just drag it down here. So now we have some clips down in our timeline. And so let's start by doing something with that. So as you see right here, you have all your options or your tools here. So let's start out by going here, and then let's just zoom in on the timeline a bit, and we can just drag that there. And as you see, it has no sound. So let's show you a little thing. If we have a clip with sound, I think this has sound. No, it's a slow-mo clip, it doesn't have sound. Let's see what we have. Also slow-mo, no sound. That's the bit of a problem with stock. It's mostly slow motion and no sound. Not to worry. But no problem, let's go to our media pool. Let's just take our rubber duck we had here. And as you see with the rubber ducks, they actually do have sound. So now we'll just do an in point and an out point. And you see these icons popping up here. If there is sound on a clip, these will appear. This means you just want to drag the video down. If you take the other one, you'll only drag the sound. And if you push in the middle and drag, you'll drag both. So just to keep that in mind as well. Okay, so let's start by looking at our editing tool. So here we have a basic tool which we can make edits with. I'll just have to zoom in a bit here. Whoops. I want to go to the start of the timeline. So for instance, if I want to delete a gap here, I can go up to edit and I can go to delete gaps, and I'll delete all the gaps. And now my clip disappeared because now they're at the front of the timeline. Just a small little tip. Anyway, this is my selection mode, which the shortcut for that would be A. So if you push A, you will be on that. Then you have your trim edit mode, which is T. And then we have a new one also, dynamic trim mode, which is W. And on a blade tool would be B for blade. So the most important shortcuts to remember in the beginning is T, A, and B, tab. And then we have also here, by inserting the clips from the top instead of dragging them. I think that is pretty fine. If we go here, we have a snapping tool. And what the snapping tool does, if we'll just enable the snapping tool, you'll see I'll just overwrite my clip by dragging it in. So I don't want to do, if I don't want to do that, I'll just push on the snapping tool and you'll see this white one appears. It doesn't mean I can't override it like this, but it'll tell me where the clip begins. Let's take the rubber duck clip here. Now we have a clip with audio. And if we now want to move that, you will of course see that they are not linked together and they are out of sync, for instance. So, but if we click our icon here and we now move it, we will see that it moves together. And then of course, the last one is if we needed to lock everything, then we would just lock our entire timeline. Okay, so again, the most important things to know in the edit tab is T, A, and B, tab. So let's start with that. So if I push A, I'll be in the selection mode. And if we take a look down at the timeline, you'll see that this one appears. So that just means you can edit by rippling here. And then you have done editing point. If you want to do a cut, you will push B and you'll have this blade here. So let's say you want to, you're watching your beautiful animal movie and you want to do a cut right away, Control B on PC and it will make a cut. Just a shortcut for that, Control Z to invert that. So that's, just keep that in mind. Okay, so I'll go to my trim mode and that is a little bit different depending on where you have your cursor. So let's say I have this clip here, but I want now the water, I don't know, the water buffalo. I don't know if it's a water buffalo. I want to make this clip longer without, you know, having to edit here. And so if I go down here and you see this icon appearing, you'll see that I'll be moving my clip in the timeline and I'll just move it slightly like that. So I can now shorten my cut pretty fast if I wanted to. If, let's say, I was at a specific frame and I wanted this frame to be the first in the, when we do the cut here, I could go up here and I'll just drag and I will move that, like that, something like that. And then we can actually see what frame we are going to cut to. So if I wanted to cut to like this, I would do it like that. And then again, we also have the dynamic trim mode, which is kind of new, that's double V. And what double V does is it makes you edit using the J, K, and L keys on your keyboard. So what you'll see here is that this is the length of the clip and I can move it forward and backwards and push K when I want it to stop. So just different way of editing. I don't use it that much, but all different. And what you actually also will see is if you use that mode, the cursor of the timeline will be yellow. I'll just push A to go back to my normal mode and you can just toggle it to go off. Actually, you can toggle it on and off by W.